Hello, I'd like to make a cake today. Transformers 4 coming up movie in June. For this recipe, what we need is 2 boxes of butter cake mix. You don't have to use butter cake mix, you can use any chocolate, vanilla, or make your own. And I'm using baking tin. It's about 21 centimeter, but about 30 to 31 centimeter. I will write everything in the description box, measurements, but you not particularly need this size, because what we will do, we actually will trim a little bit this cake. So we trim to a size about 18 by 22, so most likely we just cut edges away. So once it's mixed and baked according to instruction on the cake box you particular using, what you do is let it cool and level top with a serrated knife. Once it's done, next step is to the trim a little bit our cake. Image of Transformers, we will make Autobot and Decepticon, it will be something like that. So you can see Autobot and Decepticon and kind of versus sort of what basically this is just a print from the internet. Best idea to for really easy to make this cake is to print image on A4 paper and then to basically the what this will be. As you can see, this whole image we want to create, this is on A4 paper, and so we will trim this cake 22 in a length, and the height will be 18 centimeters. So let's do this first. Measure with your clean ruler, whatever you're using, and trim it to a size 18 by 22. Once you trim it to this size, what that would be basically 18 by 22. But as I said to you, if you wanted to leave all that here and do not trim it, that's fine. Once only difference is you just have your image on the middle, and all rest you will cover simply with black liquid food coloring. But if you want more compact image, you can trim it to size. But if you don't mind to have it just look as it is like that, just keep it without any trimming. So once we trim it, if we're going to, oops, so we place it on the cake board, and what we do is next is we apply some of the frosting. Of course, frosting will be of any your choice, whatever you prefer. I will place I will apply vanilla frosting, but depend which cake you choosing, probably that will be sort of a choice of a frosting. Nice, it's cream cheese frosting, very nice. And as well as a strawberry frosting, nice as well. It's many varieties available in supermarkets now, but as well, you can just make your normal buttercream frosting at home as well. Let's frost all over, and then we can use our fondant. Once you finish applying frosting, what we do is next, using 1 box of ready to roll icing, or use simply fondant or whatever you are able to find in your country. So what we do is with our fondant or ready to roll icing, sprinkle your working surface with powdered icing sugar to prevent sticking, and turning quite often and rolling with the rolling pin until it's a size bigger than your cake. And then just simply carefully transfer on top of your cake, and starting from top, think we need a little bit powdered ice and sugar on our hands. And we start looking from top to sides to shape our cake. As I said to you before, if you have the large party or large birthday party, you can probably leave a rectangular cake simply untrimmed, just a larger size. It doesn't really matter. You just simply place your design on the middle and rest color with the black liquid food coloring. Once you're happy with how it's come, what you do is trim it further away from stone and bring up a little bit closer again, and then trim it closer to actual cake to make it straight. Once we trim away all extras of fondant, this is what how our cake look like now. And what we do is next, as I said to you before, good idea print image of a from movie Transformers for any image of your choice. Maybe you want it colorful, maybe you want a little bit just more like an actual shape of it, not a color. It just depends, it's all everything of your choice. Print it on a size that fits your cake. As you can see, it's perfectly well fits our cake as well. So what we do is next, take a toothpick and go right around and just make a little tiny holes in all areas where the image is going, where our design, as you can see, you can put through all the little tiny corners. It makes so much easier for you. But next step is we will trim right to image, just like that, all around. We place it on and we go around with the food decorating pen. If you're able to find a black food decorating pen, which is sometimes sell separately, sometimes you can get in a packet like that, the edible food decorating pen, which is specially designed for decorating cakes, and we can eat them, obviously. And what I want to say is, but if you do not have it, what we do then, we go through all the our little dots through our cake, and we connect them in, and we just color all around with the black liquid food coloring, or you can use black gel food coloring and dilute it with clear liquid like water or clear vanilla essence or clear alcohol, for example, like vodka. But difference is, if you dilute it like something with alcohol based drink, what will happen is it's a higher alcohol contents, quicker it will dry. But if you dilute it with clear vanilla essence or water, it will dry just a tiny bit slow, but effect will be same. So do not really worry to actually, because this is water based. Now let's cut it our image first. Once we cut out, as you can see, we cut out our image just a little bit in, because we won't go around. And whatever, cut it to make sure all your image is stay in one piece. Don't cut it through, otherwise you will lose pieces, basically, which is important part of the design. Now, once you've done that, in the difficult areas like here, or some areas here, as you remember, we pierce, make it little hole with a toothpick. So, place it on top of your cake, just like I did. And, as I said to you before, if you're able to find food edible decorating pen, go around it. If you're not, use a toothpick and go through all the little areas where is, we make it little tiny holes in our design, and just a tiny bit to pointed where is you are basically, and make whole your design on a cake with a toothpick. And then once you've done that, take it out, and as you can see, let me just take it camera, I think it would be better. And as you can see, here our little tiny kind of little dots, everywhere. So what we do is, next we simply now we connect them using ruler and our food decorating pen. But as I said to you before, if you do not have food decorating pen, what you do is, using our ruler, we simply started connect all our little tiny dots we put it, and a tiny bit we make it lines everywhere. So once we done all that, we will using today only two different colors, which is white gel food coloring and black gel food coloring. That's only we're using today, and that's basically connect all together. So once we done all that, we start paint our cake with a gray color first. Now we finish outlining. As you can see, this is how our basic design look like now. So what we do is, next we will color everything what we can see here gray on our design. We will color gray. And to create gray color, we need a black gel food coloring and white gel food coloring. Take small amount of black and place it on the middle, then add white to create a gray color kind of. See, once we've done gray color, we don't need really much. Do not be precise, because after it's a little bit dry, with a sort of bristle type of brush, we add little tiny dots on this design. So we just simply start by coloring all the gray parts we need to color. With one difference only, I like to say, everything what's any side what reflects right, we leave little tiny white line. As I can see on the design, if you're able to spot it, it's just little tiny white line here. Everything which is basically makes the more stand out, sort of our kind of outshadow sort of stuff. So what we do is, we just carefully do not use too much paint, more like just try to spread it, because we will add then a little bit of the black gel food coloring as a sort of make it design a little bit more attractive, a little bit more rustic. Let's finish with a gray color. As you can see, we cover our design with a gray color, and this is what how it's look like now. And I like to actually simply just point it what I was talking about, little white line. As you can see, it's right here, and a little bit here, a little bit there, and a little bit right here and here. So all that sort of like a little bit on that side as well. So any kind, it's very small, but once we color with black, it will be visible and stand out. So what we do is, now by the time when our main design is drying, we will color rest of the cake with black liquid food color. As I said to you before, if you're not able to find a black liquid food color, use simply black gel food color and tint it with a clear liquid like vodka or the water or clear vanilla essence. I place it here because it's easier to control on a plate than taking from bottle. And so what we do is, we now take carefully, we start painting all around our design with black color. So nice and carefully. You don't need a very big brush for that. And if you able also to find it brush with a little bit angle like that, it would be even easier because it makes more straighter. You have one stroke and it's nice and straight. So we keep going and color all cake, started from middle, carefully out, and then we can cover everything with black. Once you finish applying, this is how our cake look like now. So once we finish with our black liquid food coloring, what we do is next, we're using black gel food coloring because it's much thicker, and we wanted to create a rustic style of Transformers mask. So good idea to use type of strong bristle brush because you want to just to make it like a little dots sort of basically on the cake. So what you do is take small amount of the black gel food coloring, just point it a little bit, not too much, and what you do is going in some areas and start, as you can see how I using brush, it's right perpendicular at the 90 degrees. Add it a little bit more and we just create these patches. You can make as many as you want. You can make it also a little bit darker in some areas and a little bit lighter. Now if you get a little bit more in one spot, as you can see right here, use the cream brush and go on top of it to collect it, simply rest of it, to make sure it does not look blobby, some sort of yep. And what we do is here we just simply go in and add in as much as we wanted to create our design. We can make it one side more darker than another, or we can just leave it as it is, or basically, or if you like it simply even gray, with a gray color as well, great, because it's just up to you, up to your vision of the Transformers you like to see. As I said to you before, as also, it's not necessarily to follow this particular design. You can print it from the internet, particular your design, particular design which is you like it, and just follow the basically make up template for yourself, cut it on the size of cake, and outline, and here we are, here your beautiful cake. So we keep going this way until we're completely happy with everything what we achieve. And on the end, take a clean toothpick and to make it all, because this particular design, it's perfection in the kind of geometrical way. So what we needed, we want to be perfect, and our line need to be perfect. So use a toothpick and every single line, just nice and carefully, go right around it. Just press enough to, this toothpick wasn't too good, press enough to make it this clean, nice, straight border, just a little bit. Not to levels that you actually start in tear fondant, just enough for you to see this nice and straight line. And it's make design nice and clear. And on every single one, you go in and outlining. So keep going this way. Now we finish decorating our Transformers for cake, and we finish decorating our rustic style type of Transformers mask. I hope you do like an image of this cake, and I hope you do try it as well. Thank you very much for your time with me today. Everything will be in the description box. Any questions you like to ask, please do write. Thank you very much for your time with me today. Until next time, goodbye.